It's really good to see you because of the wheel. Man, did you get it? It's because of the wheel. Because of the Falkirk wheel. It's really good to see you. I get it because I'm smart.
Yeah.
Hello and welcome back to another episode of Jack kind of tries to plan a day but doesn't really try very hard and ends up loosely piecing it together as he goes along. In today, we visit a fancy lock and a big horse. The fancy lock is called the Falkirk Wheel and is used to transport boats from down here to up there. Originally, it was set up for practical reasons, but then people saw it and were like, hey, this is pretty cool. And so then they opened a visitor center and now you can go on boat rides up and down it. It works like this, except a little bit slower. But that's less exciting, so we'll speed it up again. And if you think it maybe looks a little bit more exciting from inside the boat, you'd be wrong. But this isn't a white knuckle thrill ride, this is just a cool piece of engineering to go and look at. When you get to the top, you get to see some ducks, you get a cool view, you go in this tunnel, there's a hut. I don't know what the hut is, but it's there. But then you turn around and come down again. And coming down looks like going up, but backwards. I've been told that it works on something called Archimedes' principle, but I don't really know what that is. I just wanted to say it to make myself sound smart. It's something to do with bathtubs. Listen, the glasses don't make me smart. They just make me look smart, okay? Overall, it's really, really cool, and you should go and have a look at it. Or maybe it isn't. Really, it depends on how you feel about structural engineering and boats. There was also a gift shop where we bought such gifts as this Scottish duck, this Falkirk wheel duck, this t-shirt, and this Highland coo. I don't know if a coo is a different animal to a cow, or whether it's just the way that Scottish people say the word cow, but it said coo on the sign on the shop, in the shop, at the shop. Yes, this canal side walk is really, really pretty, and I've chosen to tell you that while we're in the industrial part, because I don't know. There were a couple of locks along the canal, which I imagine get in the way slightly when you're trying to do boat. There were also some ducks, some street art, and this swan. But that's enough about the canal. It is now time for our next attraction, which is the Kelpies. These big old horsey boys, or girls, I don't know. I can't see below the ground, so I don't know what they is. These things are genuinely horsome. They're hay-mazing.
Oh, I didn't know about that one.
They're spectacular.
Oh, no.
No? Didn't like that one? Didn't like those? I thought they were pretty good. But nay, she says.
Oh, stop.
Let's go look up this horse's nose. This is the last thing that hay sees just before it dies. This thing is crazy huge. And if it sneezes, I am dead. These things are 30 meters tall, which is very big. That's like 15 of me stacked on top of one another. As far as I know, they were built as like a tribute to horsepower because we're next to a canal and traditionally boats were pulled down a canal by a horse rather than by a diesel engine. Also, there's like a folktale about Kelpies being like these horses that live in water and murder people. I didn't read much into it because it sounded scary. It's all on Wikipedia. Listen, I know you're not here for facts. There's plenty of smart people on YouTube that do smart things and I'm not any of them. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you have enjoyed today's little adventure. As I'm sure you might be able to see, it's getting a little bit windy, so I'm gonna go. We need to go find our way back to Glasgow now, because we planned how to get here, but we didn't plan how to get back. See you next time. Bye-bye. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed that video. Here's Scout. Yes, I am wearing shorts and a raincoat. I needed to put the raincoat on to make the thumbnail. Shut up.